Hey, Speed Demons, I was recently making a huge mistake in my PowerPoint slides, and thankfully I caught myself manually replacing all my fonts, which was taking me forever. So I wanna quickly talk about how to replace all the fonts on all of your PowerPoint slides. I wanna talk about where it works, where it doesn't work, and most importantly, how to fix bad fonts from continuing to show up within your presentation. So even after I had fixed my fonts in a number of my decks, I was still getting these bad fonts. So I do want to make the point that just because you replace fonts within your presentation, and I'll show you where this is in PowerPoint in a second, does not mean that bad fonts won't continue to show up unless you fix it. So I'm going to help you out with that as well. But first off, this is what I was working with. If I just come into PowerPoint, all right, I'm working on a new course. This is the bulldozer technique. Plowing through chart formatting, next slides, you know, how does chart bling affect your charts? And a super weird thing about chart bling. And the problem was, if I came in here, I had all of this font. And here I've just made it Bell MT, but I had all of this, right? Bell MT, all through my deck. And I have like 20 different units or techniques to work through. So I was changing this all over the place, you know, clicking in, and I would change to the next one. I would click to the next slide, and then I would have to cover it, you know, all again and again and again and again, when in reality, you can just replace it all in one go. And before I show you how to replace it all in one go, I do want to make the point that this works in a number of places. First off, Slide Master, SmartArt, which was actually surprising for me. So replace fonts will go inside of a SmartArt graphic. All right, so if you have a graphic like this, it will actually change all of the fonts. So it works in SmartArt. Tables, check. Shapes, check. Text boxes. And it actually works with the note pane, but there is a little catch or a visual catch, and I'll show you how that works. The one place you really need to be careful of if you don't want that, you know, in my case, Bell MT to show up is it does not work in your charts. All right, PowerPoint will not go into a chart. If you've got something like this and you've got your data label that says 100, it will not go in and change this data label if you use the replace all fonts. So let me show you how to do this. So here I have Bell MT, all right? It's in my shapes. If I scroll zoom wheel out, Bell MT is in my charts. This is not gonna be fixed. And if I hit Control Shift H on my keyboard, notice that I also have, I just dragged up my notes pane, I select my text. All right, I also have Bell MT in my notes. All right, so to replace all fonts, you simply come up to, I'll just zoom out a little bit more. You're gonna come to the Home tab. There's the Replace dropdown. You need to open up this dropdown and you wanna select Replace fonts. And the cool thing right off the bat, this kind of threw me for a loop as well. So replace, you're only gonna see a limited number of options. This is only gonna show you the types of fonts you currently have in your presentation, as opposed to replace with, all right, is gonna give you the full onslaught of fonts. So if you come into a deck, right, and you open this up, and in my case, I'm trying to get rid of Bell MT. If Bell MT is not there, it just means it's not in your presentation, so you're good. So if you ever have a question about has someone used the wrong fonts, Home tab, just come to the Replace dropdown, select Replace Fonts, open this dropdown down, and you can see if that font is somewhere within the presentation. So in this case, I'm gonna choose Bell MT. I'm going to replace with, I'm gonna hit C to jump down to the C's. All right, and then I'm gonna click down, and I want to replace it with Century Gothic. So go ahead and find Bell MT throughout my entire presentations. It's not gonna work in the chart here in a second, as you'll see, and then I replace it with Century Gothic. Click Replace, PowerPoint goes to work, and it's done. If I now open this up, you can see Bell MT is no longer in this dropdown, all right? So this notes, and I'll show you the little trick here, is now Century Gothic, although it looks exactly the same. If I click into my shapes, Century Gothic. If I go back to my other slide, all right, Century Gothic. The one place it's not gonna work is here inside the chart. Notice the data label is still Bell MT and the category is still Bell MT. So if you have charts, you're gonna have to manually come through and replace those on your own. Now, as far as the notes, all right, notes are never gonna be formatted down here in the notes pane. So Control Shift H to open or close, Control Shift H to open or close the notes pane is never gonna show your fonts. Even if, all right, I select it, you can Control B to bold and I'll make this one red, all right? The red formatting is not gonna show, the bold formatting will show, but if you hit Control P to print, all right, come to my notes, notes pages, it's already there. You can see that Century Gothic is now there, the bold's there, and the red's there. And if you need help formatting your notes like this, just check out our other video that I'll put in the upper top hand corner. So that is how you change all your fonts, but The problem is not going to be solved if you continue to use that presentation, as I quickly found out, which is why I'm glad I caught myself and solved the solution. And here is the catch. So keeping in mind, Control Shift H to close my note pane, Alt WF to fit to screen, keeping in mind that we've already changed all the fonts, watch what happens. I'll type my name and then I'll insert a text box. And this will be the title of my slide. All right, notice there's Bell MT. Here's Taylor. It's also Bell MT, all right? Now you might be thinking, oh, the way I change this is I come to the home tab or the design tab, the drop down, all right, the fonts. Notice that I'm set at Calibri. So why the heck is Bell MT still showing up, all right? This is a catch. This is not set on the slide master. This is not set in the design tab options for your presentation. This is a default formatting thing. So after you've replaced all your fonts to set everyone up with your presentation for success, make sure you come in and change these ones. All right, I'm just gonna go Century Gothic. All right, that's what I want. Right click it and select Set as Default Shape. Selecting Set as Default Shape will ensure that the next time someone inserts a shape, all right, and they start typing Taylor, it's going to come in with the Century Gothic. All right, the replace all fonts is not gonna go in and replace your defaults if someone has set them to something else. And just a quick heads up, the same thing is true for your text boxes, all right? To PowerPoint, a shape and a text box are two entirely different object classes. So if you want your text boxes that are also inserted, again, you would wanna go to Century Gothic or just find one that's already been switched over. Again, you can change the font color if you want red to be the default color. Just make sure after you made all your format adjustments, you right click it, come and select Set as Default Text Box. I will delete the shape. I will come and grab another text box, insert, and if I type my name, you can see that that red formatting plus the Century Gothic now comes in exactly as I wanted it. So that's how to replace all the fonts on all of your PowerPoint slides and what to look out for. You wanna watch out for your charts and you wanna watch out for your default formatting. If you're new to our channel and want to keep up to date on our latest PowerPoint hack trickery, so PowerPoint hacks, tips, and tricks to get you to happy hour, make sure you subscribe in the lower right-hand corner. If you're just looking for PowerPoint resources to help get you to happy hour, like PDF cheat sheets, free courses, and other kind of jazz, just look for the links directly beneath this video. This is Taylor from Nuts and Bolts Speed Training, and I'll see you at happy hour.